We have two MacBook docks here from TOBENONE, which is one of the global companies focusing on providing computer accessories to not only Apple devices, but also Windows devices. Both are available for purchase on their website and have free shipping across the US. Feel free to check the links below to shop after this comparison review between the two docks. If you're looking for a MacBook dock, chances are you've seen several options from different brands. For the most part, they differ in styles or designs, with port selection being similar if not identical. But probably the reason why you want a dock is because you want a desktop setup at home or at work. Fortunately, we get to nitpick the perks of having a horizontal and a vertical dock. Starting with the vertical dock, this is the TOBENONE UDS201 for MacBook. This dock is meant to save desktop space as it can be placed beside or behind the monitor. Unlike most docks though, this one comes equipped with an M.2 SSD slot of up to 2TB support. So whenever you plug in your MacBook, you instantly have that extra storage. The entire build is made of metal casing that feels premium, but the main feature here is the clasp design. So when you dock your MacBook, it'll hold it in place firmly, and although the best orientation is horizontal, you can use it in vertical as well. It may look weird, but in some instances, I can imagine it being useful. The slot for the MacBook comes with rubber to prevent scratches. As for the port selection, you probably have everything you need except for a DP port. It is important to note that if you own an M1 or M2 MacBook and want to use 4K external monitors with at least 120Hz refresh rate with HDMI, you're stuck at 4K at 60Hz. But going over the ports, the back features a USB-C port where the MacBook will connect to, another USB-C with power delivery support of up to 100 watts, an HDMI with 4K 60Hz as mentioned, two USB-A ports with 5 gigabits per second of data transfer rate, and a 1 gigabit Ethernet port. Above those ports is the SSD enclosure with a metal plate accessible via a screw. The box already includes a screwdriver for the enclosure as well as a thermal pad for the SSD. However, the USB-C to C cable is for the USB-C host port, so you need to buy another USB-C cable to power the dock and use the SSD storage and continuous charging. Over to the right side of the dock are two more USB-C ports that are rated 10 gigabits per second, while the other side houses a standard size SD card slot of up to 104 megabits per second transfer rate. While one of the main reasons for having this dock is to keep your desk clean and minimal, once you use most of the ports, everything will start to look cluttered. If this is a problem, weirdly, the horizontal dock might be the one you're looking for. Enter TOBENONE USB-C docking station. This dock doubles as a rest thanks to the two sturdy hinges that hold the laptop in place. The main disadvantage of this dock is the lack of SSD enclosure. However, the advantages here are the ability to support two external monitors, a faster Ethernet port, a free 100-watt GaN charging brick, and the ability to unintentionally hide the cable mess behind the dock. That's right, for the horizontal dock, you're getting a 100-watt USB-C charging brick already. With the ports, you're also getting more than the vertical dock. At the back, you have an Ethernet port with support of up to 2.5 gigabits per second, a 1.4 DP port, and two HDMI 2.0. All three support up to 4K at 60Hz in both single and dual display modes. If you're wondering whether your MacBook supports two external monitors, TOBENONE listed the support models in the manual. The rest of the ports include two USB 3.0 with 5 gigabits per second transfer rate, a USB-C 3.2 with a 10 gigabits per second transfer rate, a 100 watt power delivery port, and two USB-C ports for connecting to the laptop. Yes, the included cable in the box will eat up two USB-C ports of your MacBook to power the dock. On the left side, you have a Kensington lock for security and another two USB-C 3.2 10 gigabit per second ports. On the right side, you have an SD card slot and a micro SD slot, as well as an audio jack and a power button for the dock. As far as versatility goes, the vertical dock seems to be the better choice given you have multiple ports for external display, more ports for external storage and devices, an audio jack for speaker and mic, as well as a faster wired internet connection. The downside to this vertical setup is you have to use your MacBook, or even if you want to try to use an external keyboard and mouse, you need significant desk space for the MacBook itself. As for the prices, the vertical dock costs 6,500 pesos or nearly $110 as of making this video, while the horizontal dock costs 14,000 pesos or $240, but is listed on sale for 10,500 pesos or $180. Take note that the cost of an M.2 SSD will increase the cost of owning a vertical dock since that's sold separately, including the charging brick. But basically, it's going to come down to your budget and needs. As for me, while I do like the horizontal dock, it's too expensive for what I need it for. The vertical dock works just fine for me, and I like the fact that I can slot in an external SSD. But that's about it for this one. Drop a sub like you feel like supporting the channel, and as always, until the next one, stay safe.